Check this out.
This is a Chinese-built railway in the heart of Kenya. Yep, you heard that right. The SGR from Nairobi to Mombasa was built by Chinese developers and paid for by Kenya mostly through Chinese loans to the tune of $3.6 billion. The idea was to create a cheaper and faster connection between the two cities through a railway that Kenya hoped would essentially pay for itself.
Except so far, it hasn't. And the reason why is a great example of why China is revamping its ambitious Belt and Road project. Let me explain. So WSJ recently published this great story on how after loaning out around $1 trillion in almost 150 countries, Chinese policymakers are now reassessing Belt and Road projects by more rigorously evaluating new projects for financing. And Kenya's SGR is just a great example of why they're doing that.
See, back in 2008, Kenya launched its Vision 2030 Economic Revitalization Plan, part of which was a plan to build a new standard gauge railway, or SGR, from the port of Mombasa to the landlocked neighbouring countries of Uganda and Rwanda.
Around the same time, China wanted to invest in foreign countries' infrastructure to create new markets for Chinese goods.
Fast forward to around 2014, and China's state-owned China Road and Bridge Corporation won a contract from Kenya without any competitive bidding to build phase one of the project, a 300-mile stretch from Mombasa to Nairobi.
Upon completion of the standard gauge railway line, transport costs in the region are expected to reduce by more than 60%.
China is ready to share her experiences.
To pay China Road and Bridge Corporation, or CRBC, Kenya took out a $3.6 billion loan from China's Exim Bank.
The idea was that revenue from the new SGR line would be used to pay back the loan. And to try and make sure it was profitable, Kenya's Port Authority made a commitment to guarantee that a certain amount of cargo would travel along the line.
Remember this point. We'll be coming back to it later.
Work started around 2014, Chinese concrete and steel was imported into Kenya, and then in 2017, 18 months ahead of schedule, and just in time for Kenya's elections, the railway was finished.
But here's the thing, since it opened, Kenya's SGR has struggled to be profitable. By 2020, it had lost some $200 million. Not ideal for a railway that's supposed to be paying for itself. So what happened?
Well, I've been wading through these documents to try and find out. To start with, Kenya's government officials questioned whether the country received good value for money, because CRBC was awarded the contract without any other competition. What's more, in 2013, when the World Bank published a study into building a standard gauge railway in Kenya, they found there was no economic or financial case to do so. See, for the new SGR to pay for itself, it has to move a lot of cargo. Some analysts estimate over 20 million tons a year, and the World Bank estimated between 20 and 55 million tons. And it just doesn't move that much. That's partly because phase one of the railway development ended at Nairobi and didn't connect up with Rwanda and Uganda. But it's also because alongside the railway line runs a road, and that's how a lot of cargo is moved. So to try and get cargo off the roads and onto the train and uphold its guarantees, Kenya's Port Authority ordered that cargo headed to Nairobi or further north had to be transported there via the SGR.
It led to protests from Mombasa locals and truck drivers. And still, even with that order, the SGR didn't move enough cargo to be profitable.
Fast forward to today, and President William Ruto has reversed the order, which means the SGR could soon be carrying even less cargo.
That casts more doubt over whether the train will ever be economically sustainable and able to pay for itself.
Kenya's Treasury and Port Authority and China's CRBC and Exim Bank didn't respond to my request for comment, and Kenya Railways referred me to their managing director, who didn't respond either. As of June 2021, Kenya still owed $3.3 billion of the initial $3.6 billion borrowed, and that's just part of Kenya's debt to China.
And it's that, combined with other expensive and underutilised infrastructure projects that China has lent money to, that has led to some Chinese policymakers rethinking Belt and Road projects.
So, are we still going to see China lending out huge sums for transportation projects around the world? After all, some analysts I spoke to said projects like the Thika Superhighway in Kenya were actually relatively successful. Well, earlier I headed into the office to speak to my WSJ YouTube colleague Shelby Holliday, who covers geopolitics. She's been looking into Belt and Road's rebranding.
Well, Chinese officials acknowledge that Belt and Road, as they initially imagined it, is just not sustainable. Not only has it left some countries with mountains of debt, but it's also hurt Chinese banks since they're having a hard time getting their money back.
Shelby told me that Chinese officials are now looking to rebrand the whole initiative as Belt and Road 2.0. And if you want to know what that looks like outside of transport, go and check out Shelby's video.
It's basically a more conservative version of Belt and Road. Think less money invested, a better job of assessing risk, a better job of sharing risk, better feasibility studies, overall just sort of trimming it down and making it more sustainable.
So if we're trimming it down, are we still going to see these grand transportation infrastructure projects deployed in foreign countries, or are they going to become a thing of the past?
I don't think we can say it's the end, but the experts I've spoken to certainly think that China will stop investing in so many big infrastructure projects and move into smaller, more nimble projects. So you can think digital infrastructure like 5G networks or small green projects like hydropower plants.
So where does this leave Kenya's plans to connect with Uganda? Well, the SGR has made it past Nairobi, but it hasn't quite made it as far as Uganda, as China is yet to give Kenya a loan for the final part.